All right, what I have here is a much heavier duty, nicer, brighter light bar, and bigger and curved for the Ram. Take out that little one in the front bumper because we decided it's going to be a little bit before we get any kind of bumper. So I just got that cheap one to try out. Now I got this awesome one here from Auxbeam, and I'll put the link in the description box of this exact light. So we got this big, heavy duty, gorgeous light bar. Got some mounting hardware and more mounting hardware. I'm not sure what the difference is here. And then they have this little sensor here that you can use as an automatic switch for your lights. So basically it's got a little eye. Focus, come on, focus. There we go. It's got a little eye, you know, that you mount on the top of your dash, run the wire, and then you can have it set to where it automatically, it's got this little switch here, where it automatically, you know, turns the light on or off, depending on if it's dark out or not. So that can be helpful. So this is pretty cool. It has the security bits on it that mount the hardware on, so it makes it, you know, just a little bit harder to for someone to steal. Not everybody has those, so that's pretty neat. They got two different kinds of brackets. And I think these are gonna work better for we're putting. So the only bad thing is it does stick out a little bit right here on the edge.
Yeah.
I mean, I could possibly do it like this.
That looks good like that. It looks good like that.
But this is plastic, so I don't know how sturdy it would be.
It's gonna be wiggling around.
Yeah. So I think, or I could do it like this.
But you're gonna have to drill the bumper.
I'm gonna have to drill the bumper no matter what.
You have to drill it anyways?
Yeah. I wonder. Back to this back hole that's used for the other brackets. Back here. Yeah, there we go. What do you think about that?
We'll see. Yeah, it goes way further back.
I just put these on here to see how they look. You know, put them on
there. I was wondering what that was.
They're just a little, you can get different colored ones like orange or.
Oh, really? Yeah. Pink?
So this is the middle. Okay, then we're going to say the middle of the A is the middle. Oops, I want to do it this way. This is the middle. We're going to say the A is the center of the truck.
Oh, sorry, truck. got them. They're not there.
All right, so I wanted to use these mounts because I think they look nicer, but they didn't fit the shape of the bumper. They would have hung off a little bit. So I had to improvise a little bit and use the other mounts that they sent and move them to the back hole here. Because if I put them on the front hole, it hung over the edge a little bit. So this is fine though. I can still adjust the angle of it like this. So what I'll do now is run the wiring, which I can just literally slide through underneath the grill here and no, I'm not leaving this other one on. And then I gotta wire in the little automatic eye here. So we'll do that here in just a sec. They do offer these little lenses you can clip on, and I believe they have them in orange as well. They just clip onto the front of the light as a little diffuser. So, man, this thing is really heavy duty, very sturdy, very good quality. It's really nice. All right, so right now I just have it hardwired in just to turn on, make sure it works. And my God, is it bright. Alright, so this is pretty simple. You get a little eye, a little light sensing eye. You mount it up on your dash. It's small. You get the wire down underneath the dash. There's three wires on the back on the, coming out of the light. One of them's for this. And the other one is power and ground. And then what you have, let me hook it up real quick and I'll show you. But then what you have is a little switch. And you have between automatic and manual. So if you put in automatic, it turns on and off by the little eye. If you put it in manual, it turns on and off by pushing the button. So definitely a cool little way to be able to wire up an auxiliary light other than just your normal, you know, little switch or something, or, you know, push button or rocker switch. So that's pretty cool that that's available to, you know, have it controlled just by lights. And you probably can use this for, you know, other lights as well. It's pretty cool. So I'm going to finish hooking this up. All right, guys, so it's pretty simple. Depending on what brackets you use, you got one or two screws that'll mount the bracket to the light bar, and then one bolt to mount it to your vehicle. And depending on what vehicle you're going to use and how you want to mount it, depends on which brackets you use. And then it's just simple power and ground. And then in this case, if you get the optional light sensor, then it's just three wires instead of two. You know, if you have a newer vehicle, they have automatic headlights that once it gets about dark like this, your headlights will automatically turn on. You have to be careful about that here in the United States because you're technically not supposed to drive with these on the road. So, but if you're off-road or something, it's perfect. So that's what I plan on using that little optional piece for. Again, this light is from Auxbeam. Check them out, auxbeam.com. I'll put the links down in the description. And I'm really impressed with the quality. It seems really heavy duty, and hopefully it'll last for a long time. Super easy install, quick, easy video. Hopefully it was useful to you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you're not subscribed yet, why not? You're missing some cool videos, and you're missing hanging out with some cool people in the comments. So subscribe, and tell your friends. Phew. Headlights, aux beam. Aux beam. Headlights. Headlights and aux beam. It's crazy. It's lighting up the whole side of the house. Headlights, aux beam. Headlights, aux beam. And fog lights. We lit.